Destiny 2 has finally come to PC, and it's specifically tuned for the platform. Bungie partnered with Vicarious Visions to make sure that it had the look and feel of a true PC game. It's also going live on Blizzard's Battle.net ecosystem, and it'll use some of the functionality. But what else separates this version from the console versions that released nearly 2 months ago? Well, here's 6 things you need to know about the PC version of Destiny 2. Competitive players will no doubt use a keyboard and mouse, but Destiny 2 still has full support for controllers. So for those more laid back and less stressful encounters, you can kick back with a controller if you want, since the game seamlessly transitions between control schemes as soon as you start using either one. Unlike keybinds, gamepad button mappings aren't fully customizable, but control options are the same as seen on consoles. While we're on the subject of controllers, Bungie and Vicarious Visions stated in a roundtable discussion that the recoil pattern for weapons is different depending on the control scheme you're using. For example, an auto rifle will have a scattered recoil pattern when using a keyboard and mouse, but the gun will pull upward when using a controller. These patterns immediately switch as soon as the game receives an input from either control scheme. As the developer stated, it wouldn't be a good design if players had to constantly swipe the mouse downward to fight the recoil, as opposed to controllers with an analog stick where that makes more sense. A big question about the PC version of Destiny 2 is how the rollout of content will be handled on the platform. The raid will be available approximately 1 week after release, giving players time to level and gear up. In talking with the developers, it's confirmed that DLC and patches will come out at the same time as well. Over time, the content cadence will be in sync across all versions. The PC version in particular may also receive patches separate from the console versions, since it'll likely need attention to platform-specific issues that may arise, like weapon balancing and potential bugs. Destiny 2 got the full PC graphical treatment with plenty of options to choose from. You'll be able to unlock the frame rate, so users with high refresh rate monitors should be happy. It also comes with that coveted FOV slider for wider viewing angles, and even accommodates 21:9 displays properly. In the beta, however, there were 3 distinct anti-aliasing options, but the final release drops one of them. The beta had issues with multi-sample anti-aliasing, or MSAA, and Bungie and Vicarious Visions stated that they couldn't get it working properly. Fast approximate anti-aliasing, or FXAA, and subpixel morphological anti-aliasing, or SMAA, are the only ones found in the menu. Supersampling is possible through increasing the render resolution. It's visually superior, but also taxes performance big time. There's also a never-before-seen ambient occlusion option available. It's simply marked as 3D in the menu, and it's proprietary tech that adds more depth to the look of object shadowing, more so than HDAO. It's similar to techniques like HBAO+. Speaking of performance and frame rate, NVIDIA did a comprehensive analysis on each graphics option, their visual differences, and their effect on frames per second. The company used a rig with a 6GB GTX 1060 video card, an Intel Core i7 6700K CPU at 4.6GHz, with a 1080p resolution for a large majority of the performance breakdown, but highlighted a few points if you want to squeeze out more frames per second without sacrificing too much visual quality. Turning off depth of field gave an extra 4 FPS. Going from an FOV of 105 to 95 saved about 2.4 FPS. Setting foliage detail distance from high to medium added 4.1 FPS. Using HDAO instead of 3D for ambient occlusion boosted frame rate by 5.4 FPS. Setting shadow quality to high instead of highest saves about 4.1 FPS. Note that using medium shadows offers a 9.4 FPS boost compared to highest. Bungie and Vicarious Visions also confirmed in the roundtable discussion that there aren't any plans to implement crossplay, even for non-competitive situations. PC players will only be able to play with other PC players, and the same goes for each console. There aren't any plans for cross-save functionality as well, so characters on each version can only be used on that particular platform. Those are some of the key differences between the PC and console versions of Destiny 2. If you want to get a better idea of how the game is as a whole, check out our full review. Or if you're ready to get started, be sure to read through our wealth of class guides and tips on GameSpot.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.